Shalom, all praises to Yahweh, Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, double honours to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and Shalom to the Akim that are teaching this word. Shalom Yahweh, Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem Rakah Kudash. As you can see here, it says Israel eases restrictions following vaccine success. All right, it says, so the state of Israel is easing, is C restrictions. All right, and how they doing that is because, you know, half the population, I read in another article, has taken the V, right? And now things are reopening and they've given them, you know, a passport to get around pretty much. All right, so this is what Esau's doing. This is one step closer to the mark, man. So I'm going to read through this article and then I'm going to read some of this article and then I'm going to read some scriptures. Okay, it says the easing comes after more than 49% of people received at least one dose of the V. Israel's easing lockdown restrictions as studies there reveal the Pfizer vaccine is 95.8% effective in preventing hospitalization and death. From Sunday, shops, libraries, and museums can open, but social distancing and masks are still required. The health ministry says it is the first stage of returning to normal life. Israel has the highest vaccination rate in the world. More than 49% of people have received at least one dose. All right, and hey, it's the state of Israel, first of all, and the people that dwell there, you know, are the Edomites that are calling themselves the people of the Lord, but they're the Edomites. All right, and then you also have the Ishmaelites there, all right, two heathens that are dwelling in that holy land. But anyway, this is all judgment of the Lord anyway, that's coming upon them, or that's coming upon the world. But the point what I'm going to read here is, you know, Esau is putting in even more measures now to further push, you know, one step closer to the mark pretty much. But I'm going to continue reading. It says the country entered its third lockdown on the 27th of December after a resurgence of the V. Under the easing measures, people are now able to enter shopping malls and tourist attractions such as zoos. A number of other facilities are now able to reopen, including gyms, hotels, and synagogues. However, they require a green passport. And this is the main point I want to get. You require now a passport to get around after you've had the V. All right? And that's basically, man, this is one step closer to the mark. You have to have a passport to get around in the society, man. And now Esau, we know that more than likely he's going to bring that to everywhere on the planet. More than likely. Or whether he might do something else or not, who knows. But, you know, these countries like Israel and like so-called other smaller countries, they do trial runs of things, you know. So they're going to do that. And they may just bring it here to Britain also. All right. So it says require a green passport. A certificate that can only be obtained once you have been V'd. A small number of people who have recovered from the virus and are not currently eligible for the V are also able to obtain the certificate. It says the passport, which is contained in an app, is issued by the health ministry and will be valid for 6 months, 1 week after the second dose. Crowds are now allowed back at concerts and sporting events have reopened at 75% capacity, but they have a cap of no more than 300 people inside and out and 500 outside. Despite the easing of restrictions, Israel's airport will remain closed for another 2 weeks. So we've been saying this for years, man, that when they start locking down this society, we've seen when it comes to the time of the mark of the beast, that what Esau is going to do is he's basically those that have complied with this with the system are going to be able to maneuver. We've been saying that are going to be able to go and move, go to shops, go to concerts, like it's reading here. And those that haven't, you're going to be outcasted, man, you know. And hey, the brothers that believe, we're going to be the ones outcasted, man. So we're coming closer to these times, the hour of temptation, all right? So it says, despite the easing of restrictions, Israel's airports will remain closed for another 2 weeks, all right? And that, I mean, that's the point of it. That's the point. The main point is that, you know, they've issued these green passports and that proves that you've been V'd, so you can now start entering bars and clubs and, you know, so that, you know, you're proving your allegiance to the beast. They that worship the beast and his image, you're proving your allegiance to it, you know. So we're coming to these times over on all the planet. All right. So I'm going to read this here. This is Ecclesiastes 7 and 7. It says, surely oppression maketh a wise man mad, and a gift destroyeth the heart. Exactly, because we know that us Israelites, brothers in the faith, you know, Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, the brothers in the faith, right? We know that we're being oppressed, man. So, you know, and we're wise because we have the scriptures. We have the understanding of what's going on. Esau controlling the planet, you know, what he's doing, you know, the pandemic that's happening right now, you know, the vaccines. We know that it's leading up to the mark of the beast, and we know that it's new old order agenda. So we're wise to these things. So it makes us mad, right? We know that we're being oppressed by these international bankers, man. And it says, a gift destroyeth the heart, man. And the gift destroying the heart is, you know, the goodies that Esau gives you within society, like the, you know, sellouts of our people, for example. They've taken gifts from Esau and, you know, they're destroyed now because you're taking a deal from the devil. What happens is when you take the deal from the devil, he always reneges in the end. You know, he does something bad to you in the end. So now in this time we're coming in, the gift is what? The gift destroying the heart is, hey, here, take this vaccination and you can, so lucky I just said it. Take this V and you get this little green passport and you get to travel around, man. Things will be back open for you again. Like making it out as if it's some exclusive thing, man. You know, take this, you know, we're going to ease. You've been locked down for so long, we're going to ease it. You just got to follow and comply to these rules. But guess what? That's going to lead to your death in the end. Because what did the scripture, because if you're willing to take the V to receive the little passport to maneuver around society, eventually when Esau comes with the actual main thing, which is the mark of the beast, you're going to be willing to receive that also, man. All right? And it says a gift destroyeth the heart, because you look, ultimately you're going to be destroyed if you participate in this society, man. So we're mad because we don't want nothing to do with this place. We understand that any little goody that Esau, any little, not goody, what's the word? Any little, what's the word I'm looking for? Any little, if Esau says, here, take this is to help you. You know, this is for the easing of the lockdown here. We know that it's more destruction coming, man. It's a destruction unto you, man. All right? So it says, better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof, and the patient in spirit is better than the proud in spirit. And this, the another point is, that better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. Yeah, we know all these things are happening, you know, the pandemic, this so-called pandemic, you know, the mark of the beast, the green passport Esau's issuing. We know all these things is happening because we're at the end of his society, all right? Esau's built up his society. He's had his great, glorious time to rule. And now he wants to fulfill his NWO agenda, man, which the main goal of the elites is to have everyone chipped. So that's what all this is all about, man. But the scripture says, better is the end of a thing than the beginning of it. So we're at the end of his society, man. We just have to overcome these last few hurdles. But we're at the end of Esau's rulership, you see? And it says, and better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. All right? Yeah, so we're at the end. Hey, we are at the end of our slavery, man. We've just got us brothers in the faith that believe in Yahweh Hashem Yahshai. We've got to overcome these last few hurdles. And hey, Lord willing, we're going to be delivered from the destruction that's coming. All right? And it says, then the beginning thereof, because hey, the beginning of our captivity, for example, was a heartache time, man. Painful, a wicked time, an evil time upon our people. More's coming. But the beginning of our slavery in the Americas was a harsh time, man. But we're at the end now of our captivity. But guess what? Esau, he's going to go into his now, man. He's gonna be in the beginning of his captivity real soon. But before that happens, we've got to overcome this oppression. We've got to overcome, you know, the V, the chips, all of that, man. And then to be delivered by Yahushua, man. Okay? So this is, I wanted to read this here. This is Malachi 1 and 4. Malachi 1 and 4, it says, whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. All right, this is talking about the Edomites, the so-called white people, right? They have returned from their, you know, low-level bestial state that they were once in to rule the world again. And they've built the desolate places. They've rebuilt their kingdom, tall buildings everywhere. This society we live in pretty much has been rebuilt by the Edomites. All right? We return and build the desolate places. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down, and they shall cool them. This is the point I wanted to get. They shall cool them the border of wickedness, all right? And the people against whom the Lord have indignation forever. Yeah, so they built this society, but the Lord's getting ready to throw it down, man. Okay? And then it says the border of wickedness and the people against whom the Lord have indignation forever. So these Edomites, they're known as the border of wickedness. And you can't say this society ain't wicked, man. The so-called white man's got the power of the earth and he wants to chip everyone. He wants to depopulate people. He wants to depopulate the planet. He wants to kill people. He wants to destroy Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. You can't tell me that they ain't a wicked person, man. And we're living in his society and he wants to have everyone chip, man. All right? So this place is the border of wickedness where everyone, you have to have a mask on your face and have a green passport to travel around. That's wicked as hell, man. You have to cover your face to travel into shops, to stores, to go into a shop. You have to have a mask on your face with a green passport, you know, and you have to have poisons pumped into your body. That's a wicked, evil demon would only does that, man. So this place, they are the border of wickedness, the Edomites, and the people against whom the Lord have indignation forever. Meaning what? Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, in the end, he's going to destroy them, man. You know, and every one of our people that's joined unto them, you're going to go with them also, man. All right? So this is what Esau is doing. So this new thing they're doing is what? The new thing that they're doing is, you know, they're giving out this, if you receive the V, you get a green passport now in, you know, in the Middle East, in Israel, and you get to pretty much travel around, pretty much get to go into the shops, get to go into the, you know, into the football arenas or whatever, you know, so-called live a normal life again, right? And anyway, this is Job 20 and 5. It says that the triumphing of the wicked is short. Job 20 and 4, actually, Salakia. He says, knowest thou not this of old, since man was placed upon earth, that the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of the hypocrite but for a moment. That's talking about the so-called white man, all right? They're triumphing. Their time to rule, this little season they've had to rule, is short. It's coming to its end now. That's why they want to fulfill that NWO agenda, man. All right? It says that the triumphing of the wicked, which is the Edomites, is short, and the joy of the hypocrite but for a moment. So their time to rule, because they are a hypocritical nation, these Edomites. All right? They're hypocrites, man. And they're the wicked. They're liars. They're hypocrites. They're the devil. They're the serpent. The old serpent. You know, and their triumphing is coming to its end, man. Their rulership. But for a moment, it says, though his excellency mount to the heavens and his cloud... Slakia. Though his excellency mount up to the heavens and his head reach unto the clouds, yet he shall perish forever like his own dung. They which have seen him shall say, where is he? And that's the so-called white man. He says his excellency mounts to the heaven. Didn't they recently, they said that they've just landed on Mars again. They've shot another rocket up to Mars and they're gonna be examining Mars. This is what Esau's saying, right? They're gonna examine Mars and see if there's life on it over the next few months to years. So his excellency's mounted to the heavens because he's able to shoot rockets into the sky and all that. But this is what the scripture says, though his excellency mount up to the heavens, and his head reach unto the clouds. And these elites, beginning with the Rothschilds, Rockefellers, right? Their head has reached to the clouds, man. Meaning they're in an extolled position. We're going to have everyone chipped. We're going to have everyone under our complete dominion. That's someone with their heads to the clouds, thinking that they're the Heavenly Father, man. It says, this is what it says in verse 7. It says, yet he shall perish forever like his own dung. They which have seen him shall say, where is he? Exactly. So he's going to perish like his own feces, pretty much. When you flush that feces down the toilet, that's how he's going to perish, man. It says, he shall fly away as a dream and shall not be found. Yea, he shall be chased away as a vision of the night. All right, and that's going to be Esau. He's going to fly away. This society we're living in, you know, we just have to keep holding firm to this truth, man, because this world that we live in is going to be done away with. You think in the next world we're going to be walking around with masks and have to have green passports to go get food and, you know, have to go to go and enjoy ourselves. This is hell, man. But this nightmare that we're living in is soon going to fly away, perish, man. It's soon going to perish, man. In verse 9 it says, the eye also which saw him shall see him no more, neither shall his place any more behold him. And that's these Edomites. They're going to be taken out of that rulership seat, man. So we have to keep enduring their wickedness, but for a little time, man. You know, this wicked world that we live in, we have to keep, just endure it for a little time. Because it's funny, because I saw the the news, and I just see these people with masks on and, talking about how happy they are to have, to be able to move again in society with a mask on and a green passport or whatever. And I thought, how stupid can you be, man? But anyway, that's it, man. That's it, man. Hey, with that, I'm just going to say all praises unto Yahweh, Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and Shalom to the Akim that are teaching this word. Shalom Yahweh, Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem Rakah Kodesh, Shalom.